Welcome back to the English language learning class. We were going on with the advanced writing skills. Till now we have covered article writing, debate, speech writing, notice writing. Three things are over. Now we are coming for advertisement. What is advertisement? When I talk about this marker, if I say whiteboard marker is very good in writing, and if I put a catchy statement or slogan or something like that, that means I'm advertising this marker. I'm giving you a lot of information about this marker so that you can purchase this. This is advertisement. Now, what is advertisement? Let us see here. An advertisement is a type of public announcement for the promotion of services or the goods, etc., or for giving information about some missing persons or missing poets or something. Information about a thing that is lost, or you want something, or you want to advertise or give information about the thing you have, that is known as advertisement or advertising a thing. It is how it is made. It is made through a popular medium that targets a large number of audiences or people. It can be through which medium? Print or electronic medium? Newspaper, TV, radios, these are popularly used for advertising. Generally, students are worried for the marks. So, distribution of the marks are for format, that is your heading is 1 mark. For content is 2 marks. Expression is 1 mark. Total, it comes for 4 marks. Now, how many kinds of advertisement are there? There are 2 types of advertisement. Now, what are those 2 types of advertisement? I'm going to put it on the board. Now, there are basically 2 types of advertisement. You can see, as I have already written here. One is classified advertisement and other one is display advertisement. So, now I am going to talk about classified advertisement, or what comes under classified advertisement. Now, this is classified advertisement, and what are the categories coming under the classified advertisement, I am going to tell you now. The first one is, categories are situation vacant or situation wanted. First, I'm going for the situation vacant. That means a post is vacant. You are giving the advertisement for your vacant post or vacancy. Okay. Now, what are the things you need to keep in your mind when you are writing for situation vacant advertisement? Okay. First thing is, keep heading. What are you going to keep the heading there? Situation vacant. You're writing for your school level, so that will be in the block letters. Situation vacant. I'm writing it here, block letters. Okay. So that you can remember that you need to write it for the block letters, and you need to underline that. Clear? You need to underline that. Okay, don't write it in this. I'm repeatedly saying use block letters. Situation vacant. Okay, rather if you are confused, I will write it for you in block letters now, because afterwards your children make mistake. Okay, then it is to be underlined. What is the second thing what you need to write is, begin with. When you're starting your this advertisement, no, you begin with the word wanted or required, because you are having a post vacant and you are you want some applicants to apply for the particular job. So in that case, you need to write wanted or required. Then mention the name of the company after that. Okay, mention the name of the company. Then how many posts you have? How many vacant posts are there with you? Number of posts lying vacant and name of the post. What is the designation to be given for that post? Then after that, the next point comes. We have completed till here. Number of posts is also over. Required age limit and educational and professional qualifications and experience. You need to mention that for your post, what qualification you require, what you are demanding from the applicant. So you need to mention, first thing is age limit, second is your educational and professional qualifications. If you have any experiences also, you want a particular experience, suppose 8 years experience, 10 years experience, 3 years experience, then you need to mention in that advertisement.
Yes, this is over. Then job requisites. Now what is job requisites? Now I'm talking to you. If you ask me certain questions, if I use Hindi then English, that means I'm not fluent. That is job requisite. What is job requisite? Job requisite means your fluency of English they will check. If you have any particular computer language or not, that also needs. Suppose for your job you need a person to be computerized. That means a person should have the knowledge regarding the computer applications. That also you need to mention. Suppose for your post, a person should be very fluent in English. So when the applicant will apply, there you need to mention that fluency of English also can be checked. So that those are job requisites. That means whatever is requirement for the job, you need to mention there. Fluency in English, computer knowledge hona chahiye. You need to write those things also. This is over. Then we come for personality requisites. What are personality requisites? That means a person should be impressive or should have a pleasing personality. You can add one or two lines to that. Next, salary. The most important thing, salary or perks. What is that? That is negotiable. That means discussion will be made. After these things, you need to write their salary. Okay. After that, what will be the mode of applying and time limit for submission? You need to mention in your advertisement how are they going to apply. What will be the mode of applying? And what will be the time limit? Ye nahi, you want a job within a week or a month and your applicants will be giving their application after that month also. So you need to mention the time limit also. Next. Contact address, if the person is going to apply, to whom the person is going to contact. You have to mention your phone number also. Remember, when you are writing the phone number, you are giving your phone number there. Don't write the particular phone number. You can begin, suppose you want to write 9861. Then after that, you can write and this. How many digits number we have? We need to write. We can put it like that, okay? You need to write the beginning numbers haphazardly and after that you can put the crosses. Don't write any particular number. If you are writing a particular number, then you have to be in problem. Maybe that number will be connected or coincidence. A number can be, any person can have that number. So you need to put XXX, okay? Start with the number, then you put XXX. Then word limit, it should not exceed 50 words. Okay, word limit will be 50. So again, I am giving you a recap. Categories under the classified advertisement. Number one is the situation vacant, situation wanted. I am going through for the situation vacant now. What are the points? Keep the heading situation vacant in block letters. Correct. Then begin with the word wanted or required. And one more thing, you need to underline that situation vacant. Don't forget about that also. And then mention the name of the company. After that, how many posts you want the applicants to apply and what is the name of the post. Then required age limit, educational or the professional qualifications or the experience. Job requisites, that means the person should have the computerized knowledge, or we can say the knowledge regarding the computer application. Then the personality should be impressive or the pleasing one. Then you need to mention the salary, this many salary, or it can be negotiable. You can write salary negotiable. Then mode of applying, what will be the mode of applying? You need to mention it in your advertisement and time limit. After that, contact address and phone number should be mentioned. And phone number, as I said, you begin with 4 digits. And after that, you can put XXX. Word limit should not exceed 50 words, 50. And one more thing, after finishing everything, put everything inside a beautiful box, make a box. Okay, remember this. I will be giving one example now. Just go through this or note down this. Now this is the advertisement. One question I have given for you. You see, one question is there for you. What is the question? You are the principal of NYPC school. Draft an advertisement for the post of receptionist in the school. Mention qualifications, experience, requirements suited to the post. I have already solved the thing. just go through this. If any doubt, you can ask me. Now this is all about situation wanted. See what are the points to mention in your advertisement. The first one, who is going to write the situation wanted? You see, the individual who seeks a job should include the following things. If you are the individual who is trying to seek a job, you need to mention in your things. You see, qualification and experience, first thing. Next is age and sex, nature of job sought, what type of job and what is the minimum salary acceptable. Then what are the contact address and phone number if anyone wants to contact you. Remember again, the word limit is 50 and you have to write situation wanted at the beginning in a block letter. After writing everything in details, you need to again make a box. After this, I'm going to put a question and solve it for you. Just go through these points and then we will be solving one question. Now this is another question related to your situation wanted. Before starting, I would like to say you can write situation wanted. If any particular thing is mentioned in your question, you can write that also. As I have given for buying a flat, I have written your flat wanted. So go through the question and as well as the solving, what I have written, how I have written, make a box, write in block letters and the details are here. Just go through this. Now this is the second one, that is sale, purchase or renting of property. Now what are the points to be kept in the mind when you are writing for this type of advertisement? The first thing is you have to keep a heading like this, for sale, or if it is for purchase, you need to write for purchase or to let. Then begin with available for sale or available for purchase or available for rent as the question comes. Then when you are mentioning for houses, then what is the type of house? That is flat or independent floors or for the office purpose you want, that thing you need to mention. What will be the size, number of rooms, details you have to give. Then locality, where it should be, where you preferably want the thing to be there. That is, it may be centrally located, facing towards the park, towards the market, nearby schools will be there, hospitals will be there, bank will be there. That means that is that will be helping you out with, according to your locality. Next. If it is to let you are writing, then you need to mention the company or the bank lease preferred, which bank they are preferring for the lease. And then expected price, it is never fixed, it can be negotiable, that also needs to be mentioned. As usual, contact address and phone number, word limit to be in 50, and after writing it, make a box. Every time I'm saying make a box, and word limit you should not exceed from more than 50. So this is all about this, and after this I'm going to put a question again with the solution. Now this is a question here. You are Deepak Raj and you want to sell your laptop. So draft a classified advertisement in about 50 words for a local daily, that is local daily newspaper, giving necessary details. Now in this I have given two options. You cannot give two options in the exam. If you are writing SELL, then you need to write to sell. If you are writing SALE, then you have to write for sale. Only one, but two options I have given for that, this reason only. If by chance you are writing SELL, then you need to make it two. If you are writing SALE, then it is to be four. So this is the thing, you write it down and remember to make a box over this. Now we are going to draft an advertisement for the missing person or the pet animals if you have. Now what are the points to be kept in the mind when you are writing an advertisement for a missing person? When you are writing for a missing person, begin with missing, the word missing, and you have to give the physical description. That means the person's name, age, sex, height, color or any other identifying features if you have any particular mark that you need to mention. And if you're writing an or drafting an advertisement for the pet animal, then you need to mention animal's name, breed, color of the fur or the skin. After that, next point what you have to mention is, for both the things you need to mention that, since when and from where it is missing. You have to show the place, or you have to mention the area from where it is missing. Then if anyone finds it and brings it to you, what is the reward if you are giving. If you want to give some reward, you need to mention that. then contact address and the phone number. Obviously, after that, you need to keep in mind that your word limit should not exceed 50. After writing your or drafting your advertisement, you need to make a box. After this, I'm going to put a question for you and it will be over. So now I have put two questions. One is for a missing person and another one is for a missing pet. Now two questions are there. You see, the first question goes like this. You are the sister of a girl who has been missing from home since last 2 days, and draft an advertisement under the caption missing for a local newspaper. Provide necessary details and also offer a reward in your advertisement. You have to mention the girl's name. Since I have given, you are the sister of a girl, mention the girl's name, age, height and color, and what is the physical quality, we can say whether it is heavily built or one. I have given your average build. Normally girls prefer to be slim and trim, so you remember that. And the date should be mentioned, and afterwards informer will be rewarded. And inform, since it is a missing thing, you need to write inform such and such which place. I have given you Ramnagar, so you put it Ramnagar police station and call at the mobile number. Remember, don't give all the numbers, put only 4 numbers. After that you can put it XX. Similarly, one more missing complaint is there for the missing pet. You can write it for a cat. I have given it for a cat. Question is like a cat. Don't write if it is asking for a dog, and since ma'am has given cat, you will put a cat there if my question comes as a dog. So I have put a question for cat. It is missing since, my date and year is mentioned here, and you have to draft an advertisement. Similarly, you have to mention the cat's name if you have given a name to your pet, and the color and the complexion and the fur and the any accessories if you have added to your cat. I have given a red ribbon round its neck. If you have, you want to write blue, you can write blue, no issues. Nothing is mentioned in the question paper. And obviously, informer to be rewarded and call at number such and such. Now see my line, this box what I have made, it is not straight. Don't give like this type of boxes in your exam, because the teacher will also notice your way of putting a box. So make a box, use a scale for making a box. I don't have such a long scale to put it here, but you people have it in your pencil boxes. So put it, put a margin or make a box using your scale. Go through this question, the solution, and after that I will be coming with the next thing. So now here another one advertisement I have given, that is lost and found. Suppose you have lost something and you may have or must have found something. Somebody else has lost. If you have found that, both lost and found column, it comes under that. Now what is the lost and found? When you are giving or drafting an advertisement for the lost and found column, what are the points you need to keep in your mind, or what are the points to be remembered? The first thing is, you need to begin with lost or found block letters. I hope you must have remembered till now. Then you have to give the briefly the physical description. If it is an object what you have lost or anything you have lost, then you need to give the name of the object. Suppose if I have lost a briefcase, then I need to write lost a briefcase. Okay. And then if it is an article or brand or any particular color, you need to mention any particular color is of that object. You need to mention everything in detail. Then next point what you need to keep in mind is, when or where did you lose that thing, or when and where did you find someone else thing. That means that is a found column. Okay. Now if you have lost something and someone is bringing that thing to you, you need to reward that person. So reward if any, or else if you have found someone's thing, you need to write found. Suppose I have lost your wristwatch, but you have found that. Then what you need to write? Found a wristwatch. But even I am writing, what I will write? Lost a wristwatch. That is only the difference what we are going to see. Now after that, for found it, for lost, you need to give all the details. But for found, details are not necessary. Remember this thing. I am underlining this point now. For lost, when you are drafting one advertisement, you have to give all the details. But for found, when you are giving, details are not necessary. Remember this point, children. Now the one question is given here. You found a wristwatch in the public park of your area. Draft an advertisement for a local newspaper in not more than 50 words. The solution is given here. Found a wristwatch. Because question is, you found a wristwatch. Just I will twist the question. You lost a wristwatch. What are you going to write there? The difference only is you need to start your advertisement with lost a wristwatch. If the question is you lost a wristwatch. Okay. Now here, when I have given the question as you found a wristwatch, I have begun it with found. If the question would have given you lost, then you need to begin lost. Understood? When the question comes you lost, you begin with lost. When the question comes found, you have to begin your advertisement with found. Now don't underline it here, because I have underlined, don't get confused. It is only to explain. You need to underline this lost and found. It is in block letters. And then one more thing, mobile numbers, as I have told, don't mention all the numbers. And one more thing, you have to put everything inside a box. Is it clear? After this, I will be giving you the categories of the classified advertisement. Now, these all things comes under the categories of classified advertisement. Okay. Already we have discussed here till lost and found. You can see that is the first one was situation vacant, situation wanted, sale, purchase or properties of the vehicles, missing person or the pet animals, lost and found. This many things we have already done with the questions. If you have a doubt, you can come under the travel and tour or the packers and movers. What is that? What you need to write is what kind of, suppose you need to mention the package available for 2 days, 1 night or 3 days, 2 nights, something like that you need to write. And what are the cost of the package, entire package, and it consists of these same facilities. That comes under the travels and tours. Education and language course or hobby class. Suppose a new coaching center is going to open and that you are offering certain foreign languages. You need to write for commencement of the foreign languages is going to happen in this and so, such and such faculty is coming. These things are offered here or taught here, and these are the criteria. If you want to join, then you can contact. Normally, you people know about the coaching classes. Then comes for the matrimonial, very pretty column, we can say matrimonial. Bride wanted or groom wanted. Mostly you can see in the newspapers also. If it is a bride, then you need to describe the quality of a beautiful lady. And if it is coming for the groom, then you need to write tall, dark, handsome and everything. But at the beginning of the groom, you need to write groom. If you are writing for a bride, then you need to write her bride, capital letter. Underline, write everything. Word limit should not exceed from 50, and make a box using your scale. So these things are all under the classified advertisement. So today we are coming to end of the session of classified advertisement. In the next video, I'm going to teach you or tell you about display. That means whatever we have written, this was writing purpose, that is artistic way. We need to draw something, show something. That means hum log bahut jaldi ड्रॉइंग टीचर बनने वाले इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन. सो टिल देन हैव अ नाइस डे, स्टे होम, स्टे सेफ, बट येट स्टिल वन मोर वार्निंग, कंटिन्यू लर्निंग.